My dear brothers and sisters, accept my greetings in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I am Reverend Father Eswa Andrew, a Claritian missionary in the Holy Roman Catholic Church. If I'm coming up today, it is because of the degrading situation going on in Southern Cameroon. As I speak to you today, the 18th of September 2018, Southern Cameroonians are fleeing Southern Cameroons to the French Cameroons. Yes, there is mass exodus. Why? Because of violence. I will never support violence, and I will never support the oppressor. And the oppressor is the government of Cameroon. I'm so ashamed because those killing themselves, be it the military, defending the government, be it my own children who have picked up arms. Killing is killing. Killing is killing and has grave consequences. I feel so bad because all of them are Christians, starting from the head of state, President Paul Biya, who declared the war. The earlier you come out yourself and declare a ceasefire, the better. You declare the war. To call a spade a spade. He's a Catholic. You go to the Prime Minister, head of government, Philemon Yang. I know his community near Tugabe. All these guys are Christians. Tanganji, Lorna Esso, many of these other guys, they're all Christians. What has gone wrong to their souls that they derive joy in killing in order to protect their political dignity, rejecting the human dignity that they are supposed to protect? They hide behind this crisis and commit all types of sins. Let us pray for them, my dear brothers and sisters, because if their souls have been hijacked by the devil, if they have surrendered their souls or they have offered their souls to the devil, we have a divine responsibility to pray for their deliverance. Yes. I have something for them. Thus says the Lord in Ezekiel chapter 2. Son of man, I have appointed you a sentry to the house of Israel. Whenever you hear a word from me, warn them in my name. If I say to a wicked man, you are to die, and you do not warn him, if you do not speak and warn him to renounce his evil ways and so live, then he shall die for his sin. But I will hold you responsible for his death. If, however, you do warn a wicked man and he does not renounce his wickedness and his evil ways, then he shall die for his sin, but you yourself will have saved your life. When the upright man renounces his integrity to do evil, and I set a trap for him, he too shall die. Since you failed to warn him, he shall die for his sin, and the integrity he practiced will no longer be remembered. But I will hold you responsible for his death. If, however, you warn the upright man not to sin, and he abstains from sinning, he shall live thanks to your warning, and you too will have saved your life. The good news here is that you, the government leaders, you are people of integrity, which the scripture, God recognizes and calls you even upright people. You are supposed to protect the children of God. That is your responsibility. But the Lord says, but if you take upon yourself violence to kill the children of God, you will not only suffer here, you will suffer there. And not only you will suffer, your children will suffer. I pity your innocent children and families where you guys are from. I pity them because they're enjoying blood money now, being generated from this crisis. But the Lord says, if you change, he will receive you. Yes, I don't know what has happened to you guys. That killing means nothing. I hear Atanganji the other day saying, oh yeah, we're going to bring them back from the United States and they'll come back here. Yeah, you guys brought some from Nigeria to date 7 to 8 months today. We have never seen them. We've never heard that in the history of Cameroons. Yes. But we are seeing that today. Why all this wickedness? The worst thing that is happening today is people are fleeing this war zone you people declared. They are fleeing to seek for refuge in the French zone. And you are obliging them to seek for permission before moving. It therefore means you recognize the Federal Republic of Ambazonia. It means it's an embassy because there is no constitution in Cameroon that warrants any Cameroonian to seek for permission from any civil authority to go to any region. Any region. There is no law like that. What has Southern Cameroonians done? What have they done? What did our parents do that we are suffering today? Where did they go wrong? Why this wickedness on Southern Cameroonians that has given room to some selfish individuals to manipulate our society? Our parents joined the Francophone Republic because they wanted a peaceful nation. They wanted a joyful nation. But from this crisis, we have seen that the government of Mr. Biya, not the Francophones, the government of Mr. Biya is bent on dividing Cameroon. With this one now, it's already a division. It means the English-speaking Cameroonians have no right to go to the French-speaking Cameroonians except the proof that they are worthy. My dear brothers and sisters, I feel so bad. Where did we go wrong? And when we look at how things are going, now they are running away. Who started this? You forgot that you have been sending out letters of curfew that people should not move out from before 6 a.m. and they should be indoors before 6 p.m. Some at times 9 p.m. You forgot that these people, most of them are peasant farmers. They leave their houses at times 3 a.m., 4 a.m. to trek distances to go to their farms. And you block them in their homes to leave as from 6 p.m. to hurry back. Some that try to go, you kill them. Today, they are no longer feeling comfortable. They want to go where they will feel comfortable. You say, no, don't go. Stay. You should also know it. Something is wrong somewhere. You people have lost it. You have created an uncomfortable zone. They want to leave you there. Be it you, the governor of Southwest Region. You call people dogs. Yeah, they are dogs. They want to leave the region for you. You are a governor because there are people. They say, okay, we are leaving the region for you. Now you can be a governor of the houses, the trees, the lands, and the animals. And you are crying. You don't want them to go. You are blocking them. They stay. You come and kill them. They don't feel secured. Today we hear about Amber boys. Today we hear about Atanganji boys. The other day we hear about the military. The military or whosoever has arm and is killing the other has no right. And we can never support that. The military men and women, they also deserve to live. Why all this wickedness? What has Southern Cameroonians done to merit this type of wickedness? We hear about the maltreatment some of them have in Yaoundé, Douala, and other places. How they have been maltreated. Why this hatred? What have they done? And tomorrow we talk about elections. I will say there should be no election. No Southern Cameroonian with a good mind should go for any election in Southern Cameroon. Nobody. May no man not go. Make a talk and me all my year. That election, may no man not go. When I go to wait for them. Go elect people where they can't kill me again. We know how they do their thing. Make them just do one after the first one. When I vote, they don't vote, they will still be president. Yes, they vote or they don't vote, Biya will still be the president. Why troubling them and traumatizing them? Let them go where they want to feel free. Let them go. When I go, so when I feel hide, when I go hide in my head. When I walk out for night, when I go. Because the truth, I say the one key omen. It's clear. They say you kill. You have killed so many young men. Many of them are languishing in prisons in different areas. Many of them, you have buried them in mass graves. We know all those graves. But there's a day of reckoning. But I have one bad news for you today. That you like it or not, the hatred you have shown the Southern Cameroonians, Cameroon will never live together again with Southern Cameroons. It's over. It's over. The hatred you have shown is a proof that the two cultures can be together. Unfortunately, you can't carry your different geographical dimensions. You cannot carry your different geographical locations to other areas. You must live in the same geographical location. The area you declare the ceasefire, the better, so that people can reconcile. As Martin Luther King Jr. said, "I have a dream. One day the blacks and the whites will sit on the same table." It's the same dream I'm saying today. That I have that dream. You like it or not, either this generation or the next, the two Cameroons will never be together. It's impossible. It's not possible. Yes, it's impossible. They must separate one day, either now or later. The two cultures are different. The earlier they separate and live as brothers and sisters and enjoy the different beauty of their territories, the better. My dear brothers and sisters, there are some they call elites. Look at them the other day, they were escorted by bees and military to Boya to have a meeting. And they went there and declared that Biya should militarize again the southwest and northwest regions. Who is an elite? An elite is somebody who has invested in his place. Public investment. Somebody who has helped in any type of development in his place. That's an elite. When he goes there, he feels free. He's welcome. And these are our own elites of the Southern Cameroons. Even the road to their villages, they are unable to even go there. Many of them don't even have houses in Southern Cameroons. They call themselves elites. I just laughed and I said, elites. To be an elite is to gain membership in CPDM or in the government. Then you are an elite. What a shame. But there's time for everything. The earlier you make U-turn and fight for your people, the better. It's becoming too late. Because even Cameroon, the French Cameroons, what I see coming there, they will also feel the pinch. They will feel the pinch very soon. Yes, Southern Cameroonians will feel the pains till now. Don't cry. Very soon, French Cameroon will suffer. They will also cry. Yes, because we all have been like Mbutukus. Yes, Lapiro said it, Ere from Butuku na Damin Fondos. We have allowed them to change the constitutions, manipulate the constitutions as they want. And today they are the Ndos and we are the Butukus. Yes. They have done whatever they want to do with the country. We trusted them today. We are seeing their true faces. Even those who wanted to build Cameroon were chased. Many of them are on exile. many of them locked up in prisons because they wanted to help the nation be what it's supposed to be. Our nation has been hijacked. The devil is using the crisis to suck blood. But we have to fight. We have to rise up as Christians and fight this battle. We have to fight it out. Yes, we have to fight it out. If we don't fight it out, the devil is going to crush all of us. We saw the other day how the chiefs of Ebolova, they were doing their incantation so that Paul Biya can be re-elected. Yes, they believe in their gods. You Christians, we Christians, what are we doing? We have been praying. I think it's high time for us to step up our prayers. We should step up our prayers and pray. And pray. Because the nation Cameroon is underwater. As the other time, the death of the bishop, they wrote a note and kept in his car that he's under the water. Yes, he was not under the water. I made one of the videos and said, it is Cameroon that is under the water, not the bishop. And that Cameroon is under that water. It's not moving. And it's not going to be so sweet in the future. My bad news is that, they like it or not, what they are afraid, what they are hiding, shall be exposed. Let us go in for prayers. C'est pour cela qu'il y a mes chers frères et sœurs francophones. Oui, vous êtes tranquilles dans la zone francophone, que tout va bien, le Cameroun va bien. On tue le peuple anglophone au Cameroun. Certains même encouragent, certains même disent que non, ce sont des animaux, il faut les tuer, ce sont des terroristes. Vous êtes content pour les appeler les terroristes. Aujourd'hui, le gouverneur du Sud-Ouest, les délégués au Nord-Ouest demandent les anglophones pour demander permission chez le sous-préfet ou le préfet avant d'aller dans le côté francophone. Voilà le Cameroun que nous disons que un et uni. Aujourd'hui, les anglophones doivent demander permission. Quelle constitution du Cameroun fait que les gens peuvent demander la permission pour voyager? C'est une preuve déjà que le gouvernement lui-même a approuvé cette république qu'on appelle la République fédérale d'Ambazonie. Le gouvernement lui-même a approuvé que les gens doivent demander la permission avant d'aller dans le côté francophone. Qu'est-ce que les anglophones ont fait pour mériter ce traitement? Qu'on les traite comme des sauvages. Beaucoup, nous tous, beaucoup sont des chrétiens qui se mettent dans cette crise, qui en profitent pour s'enrichir. Ils sont dans le gouvernement. Quel cœur qu'ils ont développé. Quel cœur qu'ils ont développé. Nous devons prier. Nous avons la responsabilité divine pour prier et délivrer certaines de ces autorités-là qui veulent mettre ce pays dans l'eau. Le pays est déjà dans l'eau. Quand ils ont tué Monseigneur Bala, ils ont dit qu'il était dans l'eau. C'était le Cameroun qui était dans l'eau. Ah oui. Et certains vont se lever. Non, c'est interdit pour parler de cette crise. Même dans certaines maisons, même religieuses, c'est interdit de parler de cette crise. Ils ne veulent rien entendre. Parce que ça ne les touche pas. Parce que leurs parents dorment en paix. Ils boivent la bière. Tout va bien. Le Cameroun va bien. Mais malheureusement, dans bientôt, même le côté francophone va aussi sentir ça. C'est que le gouvernement camerounais cache aux nos frères francophones va se révéler. Le peuple anglophone n'a rien contre le peuple francophone. Mais le gouvernement Paul Biya veut semer cette haine. Et il a réussi. Et la mauvaise nouvelle que j'ai pour vous est que vous faites quoi? Vous faites quoi? Soit maintenant ou demain, il y aura une séparation de ces deux Camerouns qui se sont mis ensemble. Ces deux Camerouns, ils vont se séparer. Soit cette génération ou à venir. Parce que la haine que le gouvernement Biya a semée dans le cœur des anglophones est inexplicable. Sans quelques villages éradiqués, brûlés, milliers de personnes tuées. On ne veut même pas se rappeler de ce qui s'est passé à Lac-Nios. On ne veut même pas se rappeler. Qu'est-ce que ces peuples ont fait? pour mériter ce genre de traitement, comme des sauvages. Aujourd'hui, ils ont pris les armes. On les appelle les terroristes, les sécessionnistes. Et les gens se lèvent et disent les terroristes, les sécessionnistes. Aujourd'hui, ils trouvent leur protection à côté des armes. On ne peut jamais supporter la violence. Moi, je ne peux jamais. Pour tuer les uns les autres, nous, même les militaires camerounais qu'on envoie là-bas pour aller combattre leurs frères et sœurs, ce n'était pas leur objectif d'être des militaires. Leur objectif était pour protéger le pays, protéger le Cameroun. Pas tuer leurs frères et sœurs. Aujourd'hui, ils sont manipulés, obligés, drogués, même envoyés là-bas pour tuer. Beaucoup reviennent sans vie. Et nous tous, nous sommes tranquilles que le Cameroun va bien. Le Cameroun va bien. Dans bientôt, ce que je vois là, même le côté francophone aussi, va saigner. Et vous allez comprendre que le diable a déjà capturé le Cameroun et va faire du Cameroun ce qu'il veut. Nous les chrétiens, c'est juste une invitation que nous prions chaque matin, chaque soir. Prions pour le Cameroun, pour la délivrance du Cameroun entre les mains des malfaiteurs, ceux qui en profitent pour semer la haine, qui va demander des années pour guérir. Let us pray so that Cameroon be delivered from the hands of wicked men and women. Cameroon, Cameroon, what is coming in will be bad. I pray for the souls of those that have gone. And I pray for those who are in prisons. Innocently, they find themselves to the psychological torture is more than anything. We are praying for you. Praying for those who are fighting. But all those who are using the occasion to make money, be it from any corner, be it from Southern Cameroon, be it from the French government, that you are manipulating the crisis to make money. No, you shall pay for it. You shall pay for it. God bless you all.